We are used to thinking that just one brand is usually just one big company, but that's not always the case. For example, Facebook has many different entities all over the world that interact with the same leadership and follow the same structure. We're going to talk about different kinds of organizations and their components. The parent company is usually the entity that holds the share of all the other companies within the group. For example, Facebook Incorporated is the owner of all shares of Instagram, WhatsApp, Oculus, Atlas, and others. All these companies that are under a bigger company are called subsidiaries and report directly to Facebook. Let's imagine that Facebook is WhatsApp's boss. He would ask for reports regarding sales, performance, etc. The subsidiaries get instructions and goals just like how you would get from your boss. Global companies like Facebook and Coca-Cola have offices all over the world, but they do have one main office called their headquarters. The headquarters is where all of the top level CFO, CTO, and C-level positions operate their business. Let's imagine that the headquarters is the brain of the company, so the plants or factories are the muscles of the company. These facilities transform raw materials into the finished products, and they can be scattered all around the world depending on where the company can get the best materials and the most qualified workforce. When companies such as banks have offices in different cities to serve more clients, these are called branches. Branches are really important because these are like smaller headquarters. These basically provide sales information and different types of products and services to new clients. In branches, you can expect to find different departments such as marketing, sales, logistics, and customer service. Stores, on the other hand, are just like branches, except they just sell products and services. There are actually several different types of stores. For example, outlets offer huge discounts, and they're usually for clothing, for example, that don't sell very often or from different seasons. Another type of store are called pop-ups. These are usually temporary locations that are easily put up and easily taken down. For example, when you go to a concert and you buy t-shirts or something from the band, these are usually pop-ups. I hope my explanation of organizations has been helpful and also help you in the English business world. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you can get more updates on Yappy Corporate's channel.